This is your day to experience God's answered prayer in your life, your day for miracles. Have you prayed? If so, have you prayed believing? Let's believe God. Let's see how we can experience answers to our prayers. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. Yes, God answers prayer. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Him. Every day is a day in which I've got to trust Him for a new miracle. You see, we receive no city, state, or federal dollars and no United Way dollars. So when we have to believe and ask the Lord for like $10,000 a day. And sometimes we feel like we're being brought right to the very brink. And some days we get $1,000 in. We thank God for that, or two or three. But then the bills just keep mounting. And so I'd get down and say, Lord, we need a miracle. So I got down and praying. I said, dear God, we got to have a miracle. I'm praying that again right now, a couple of weeks ago. And He sent a church from Cahokia, Illinois. The Lord spoke to the pastor's heart. And He sent a check for $50,000. Mm-hmm. Well, now the bills that are due are still back up to $250. But I stop and I think, well, Lord, if that pastor hadn't been obedient to the Lord, that could have been a wipeout at that time. And then there's times that the Lord would just move and speak to somebody's heart. He'll share $5,000 or $10,000, others $500. I mean, it's just right on time. Well, Shelly's joining me at this particular time. And Shelly, you seen some answers to prayer?
I certainly have, Reverend Rice. I went through a very dark period of time in 2011 and very, very depressed and feeling that there was no hope whatsoever. And it was really at that time I became more prayerful. To stop all of the noise in my head. I was unable to sleep. And it was through that sort of prayer that God came through. God answered it. And it wasn't very long, really and truly. It was a couple of weeks when I was just so very fervently praying that I was able to sleep at night. Some of that depression was alleviated. And it wasn't because of my own doing. It was through the help of my Lord.
And so you give Him the glory.
Without a doubt.
Yes, He is a miracle-working God. I'd like to go to Bernie at this time. He's talking to a special guest, Maribeth. And wow, there's a tremendous organization that she's in charge of there. And she's going to talk a little about a prayer to you.
Hello, I'm Bernie Hayes. And with me is the president of the National Convention of Gospel Choirs and Choruses, Dr. Maribeth Gentry, a native St. Louis. And Dr. Gentry, welcome.
Thank you. Welcome, Bernie. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, such a pleasure.
I'm just elated.
And you've always been a supporter of Dr. Larry Rice and the New Life Evangelistic Center. Tell us why you support New Life and why in different cities you always go to help the homeless.
Because that's where God was. See, God was not, He very seldom lived and stayed in the temple. He went among the people where He could help. Mm-hmm. And that's what we've got that a little backwards, I think, sometimes. We think going to churches is all that's necessary. No, I feel responsible. My parents taught me that. From 1968, we worked in a homeless shelter for the Salvation Army for, ooh, gosh, when I was in college. Mm-hmm. And they ingrained in me that you need to go out. And that's where the help is, helping the people. If you can bring a smile on a person's face who doesn't have anything in his life but what is given to him at the shelter here or other places, then that's what God wants us, to bring joy to people that would not even feel joy.
What do you get out of helping others, Dr. Gentry?
Joy. It's a thing of where I said, boy, if somebody would do that for me, I would be grateful. And it's the feeling that you have done something other than something for yourself.
Mm-hmm. That's also the power of prayer. You said you say instant prayer sometimes, and some oftentimes is long-term prayer. Tell us about your prayers.
That I have, where prayers have been delayed but not denied. Mm-hmm. See, a lot of times we think, oh, God, I've been asking you this for 25 or 30 years. And maybe the 35th year you're going to get that, which means it wasn't denied to you, but it was just delayed at when God thought that it would be best suited in your life. Mm-hmm. And then there's that what you call quickening, that quick prayer. You say, Jesus, that's all you have time to say. And He stretches out His hand and saves you from something that could be, a catastrophe. Sure. And so we thank God for that. There's instant prayer and then those long prayers that seem to be.
Mm-hmm. What has your spirituality and faith done for you? And what can it do for others?
It's the sustaining. Mm-hmm. Spirituality sustains you because when you really, you never get to the point where you always feel that, oh, there is hope. You know, and you can get, everybody can get down. I don't care what your belief is. You can get down, but then you wake up and you say, I have hope. This thing is going to get better. The Lord's going to bring me out of this. Okay. That's the good part about being religious is I know in the end I'm going to win.
Some people who live in close proximity to the New Life Evangelistic Center don't want to see homeless people coming in here. They don't want to see poor people. They think, they look down on them. What do you think about that?
I just said, a lot of people don't realize it, but a lot of people just one paycheck away from that, from being where you don't have any source of income. So don't ever look down. Be thankful rather than to be arrogant about it, because you are setting yourself up for a rude awakening. The homeless will be here always. They've had them since the beginning of time, and they're going to be there. So you might as well help the persons who, these are still God's people. I don't know where everybody thinks, well, because they're homeless, that God's not. No, everybody can't be of the same status or have the same amount of money. So you have to be thankful for what you are and give a helping hand. Don't stick your foot out. Give a helping hand to a person who is, don't kick them while they're down, because you don't know when your day is coming.
How thankful are you?
Oh, God. I'm truly thankful when I wake up and I have a bed to sleep in and I can watch a little TV or the air conditioner or whatever. That's a lot to be thankful for, Bernie. It mm-hmm. really is. And that's why we need to support the New Life Evangelistical Center, because they need, that it's comfortable. Those persons, it is horrible out there. In the street, be it bitter cold or extreme heat.
Yeah.
Everybody needs
those
somewhere to come.
Yeah. Life-threatening conditions. Yeah.
Yeah.
Dr. Marybeth Gentry, you've been so kind. Thank you for stopping by and supporting the Life Evangelistic Center, Reverend Larry Rice, and all the ministries here.
Well,
we continue
most
to bless
certainly.
Your ministries.
And anything I can do to help.
You always have.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Bernie Hayes. Thank you for watching.
Yes, God answers prayer. And perhaps the opportunities I'm talking to you about here, where you can help hurting and homeless people, is an answer to the prayer that's been on your heart to help those in need. We give you opportunities here at New Life Evangelistic Center, whether it's 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri, 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis, or a host of other locations, opportunities to just share Jesus with people. Tell everyone your name.
Davion.
Davion, you came here to New Life Evangelistic Center,
yes.
Homeless, didn't have a place to go.
Yes.
How's it been helping you?
It's been helping me a lot.
Well, Davion, you know, we want to do more than just give you a place to stay, food to eat, opportunity to help others. We want you to know the power of God and the power of prayer. You go out there and you just keep trying to live without Jesus. What happens?
It ain't working.
What?
It's not working.
You tried it?
Yeah.
And it's not working, right?
No.
Well, you're taking the first step. You've been honest. That's it. Be honest. God, it's not working.
Yeah.
You want His help?
Yeah, and it's been working.
So you need some help, right?
Yeah.
Right. And this is a holistic program here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. It not only deals with the physical, the mental, but the spiritual. David, would you like to learn some more about prayer and how to pray?
Yes, for sure.
Well, first of all, Jesus shows us explicitly in the Lord's Prayer. You ever heard that prayer? Our Father who art in heaven, mm-hmm. hallowed be thy name. Instead of, often our prayers are, my kingdom come. He says, thy kingdom come, mm-hmm. you know. So first we got to get things right. Jesus says, but first the kingdom of God and all these things shall be added unto you.
Yeah.
Thy kingdom come, instead of my kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Often our prayers are, my will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So mm-hmm. we got to be willing to surrender ourselves to Him. So to speak, some refer to it as dying to ourselves. Sometimes yes. giving our lives to Jesus, but somewhere coming to the point that we're sick and tired of being sick and tired. You ever get that way?
Yes.
Been there, done that, tried this.
Mm-hmm.
Thank God you're still alive.
Right.
Could have been wiped out by this time, couldn't you?
So should have been.
Should have been. What happened?
God gave me a second chance and cleaned me up. I was on drugs real bad.
So you're coming out of it. Praise God, a second chance. Yes, he's a God of the second chance. Praise the Lord. As many as call upon the name of the Lord, they shall be called the children of God, the scripture says. He says, come unto me, all you who labor, you try to yourself and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. So come to Jesus. And so that's what we do here. We go and, you know, try to get that through. You know, they can't substitute this program that where the Holy Spirit is moving. That's why Satan tries to stop New Life so much, because he knows that here people are going to hear about Jesus. He'd love to break them down. He'd love to have the city try to do what's going on here, but they can't do it because, you know, they get all the federal dollars. So we don't take that because we want to be free to share that there is hope with Davion and others, that Christ is risen. Want them to experience that, and we want to just, through the love of Jesus, share with everyone. Love of Jesus. So, first of all, you know, we're looking at the Lord's Prayer, remember? Mm-hmm. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, yes. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses, so we forgive those who trespass against us. If somebody's really hurt you, somebody really hurt you.
Yeah, a lot of people.
A lot of people really done you wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Like to get even with them?
No, I don't want to get
even. You going to forgive them?
Yeah.
You want God to forgive you, right?
Yeah.
Yes. And then we ask him for our daily bread. Give us this day our daily bread, you know. Well, a lot of that can be summed up when spelling out the word axe, okay? Mm-hmm. You know how to spell that, don't you? What? A?
A-X-E.
Axe. A-C-T-S.
Mm.
Yeah, axe.
Oh, axe.
Yeah,
oh,
axe.
Yeah.
Like axe. Right, no, this is A-C-T-S. You got it. A-C-T-S. Yeah. All right, each letter stands for something, okay? Mm. The A refers to adoration, where we just, first of all, get it clear in our head that God is bigger than all that. You can think about who created all the stuff, right?
Yes.
Great God, adoration, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then the next one is C. And you started moving on the C a little bit over there, where you're saying, okay, God, I need some help. I can't do this myself. I ask you to forgive me for our sins, you know, that whole stuff. So adoration, the C is confession, the T is thanksgiving.
Yeah.
You ever thank God for something?
A lot of things.
Yeah. Attitude of gratitude. So you engage in the thanksgiving. Then finally get to the S of the supplication. Give us this day our daily bread. So A-C-T-S, okay? Now you don't need the axe. Like, you need the axe of the apostles, the axe of God, the power of God in his life. Adoration, confession, thanksgiving, supplication. Just go to God in prayer. Watch answers to your prayers. The Holy Spirit is moving in such a special, mighty way. And I thank God for the testimonies that are coming forth from among the homeless.
My name is John. I've been in Springfield for a little bit over 4 months. Things have been pretty tough, but I'm pretty sure God has had his hand on it. When I first came here, I was pretty confused. I was pretty upset. I was passing blame to the wrong people. But I also read where God says he chastises those he loves. But through everything else, I was able to had to really lean on the Lord since I became homeless. And since then, I've been blessed with a job. I've been blessed with being able to keep a job, and a better opportunity has come my way. And I don't think I'll ever be in this situation again, but I will remember everything I had, every time I had to have faith. There was a lot of times in this past 3 months that I've had to lean on God, and I don't think anyone else would have been there to help me. And if it wasn't for him, I don't know where I would be.
Hi, my name's Sherry. The Creator has impacted my life in many ways, mostly by showing me a lot of things to give me patience and understanding. And I appreciate all the lessons that I've learned and the lessons that I'll continue to learn. At the VA, they offer many services. They allow you computer time, and you're allowed to wash a load of laundry and dry it. You can sign up for shower time and get personal hygiene and care items. They even offer dog and cat food every so often when they have it. They serve lunch and breakfast and snacks most of the time in between. They have plenty of room to lay down or sit and enjoy yourself and relax. Being on the streets, you walk around a lot, so they have resting places where you can get rest and enjoy cot and all that stuff. You can receive your mail here and even use the phone if you have to get interviews or to have people call you if you need. They offer a lot of services and they're very kind to the homeless and to the veteran, you know, population here. We appreciate them very much. Have a great day.
Yes, God answers prayer. He's doing miracles. I'm just so encouraged when I hear people that maybe be going through some tough times and they're testifying to what the Lord is doing. And he's working through each one of you. We give you opportunities to be a part of the miracles God is doing, the two you heard from. Coming to you from 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. Jennifer's with me. She'd come in here. I think you came in at nights and stayed at 1411 Locust. Is that correct? Was that an answer to your prayers?
Yes, it was. It sure was.
And can you recall answers to your prayers?
Many answers to my prayers. I came here from another city. I didn't know anyone. I was new. No family here, so... Yeah.
You've indicated you wanted to get involved in a training program we have here.
Correct.
How does it make you feel to help other people?
It's gratifying would be a good word. Sometimes we need to get outside of ourselves, especially if you've got a lot of issues going on, personal issues. It's good sometimes to get outside of yourself and maybe see other people's stories. It might help you realize that the things you've been through or are currently going through might not be as bad as someone else's story. And it's helped me that way.
That's right. And we thank God for the opportunities we have for you to help others through our volunteer outreaches here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Whether it's 806 North Jefferson in Springfield or Marshfield or Joplin. I was in Joplin the other day and met some tremendous volunteers there. Or whether it is in Potosi or Van Buren, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. Pam, she's been helping out there. Let's hear from Pam.
Hi, I'm Pam, and I'm here today to help feed the vets. And in the middle of the night, 6 or 8 months ago, I woke up thinking I need to do more. And I have so many uncles and cousins that have been in the service, and it breaks my heart to see people really hurting for things. And I just thought, well, the least I can do, I'd love to cook. I have a church that is really giving, and so I asked permission if I could start feeding here at least once a month. And I'm working on more, but right now we have a good amount of help that are all pitching in, and my church is even giving me some money for the main courses. Price cutter. I have my son-in-law works there, and he is furnishing the main courses for me, and it just seems like God has just brought this plan together. It's really kind of a miracle and how it's growing. And I'm just starting a clothing drive at church for the vets and for some summer clothes that I understand that they're really needing. And it has blessed my life probably way more than it's blessing the vets. But I had a heart attack back in February, and at that point I've got to serve. I think God kept me alive for a reason, and this is where my heart is. So I'll help as long as I'm able, and just God bless all the vets. And I also had one very good friend that died of Agent Orange not too long ago from Vietnam, and it's just not right that we're not helping the vets more, and I'm going to be a big cheerleader for it and do all I can to help.
There's so many opportunities available to you at the New Life Evangelistic Center among the hurting, the homeless, the incarcerated, their families. Wow, there's so many ways that you can make a big difference for good. And I thank God for those that are coming forth and getting involved. In fact, we have a series of special programs here to help those that are homeless help themselves. 30-day transitional housing program, 90-day program, 2-year leadership program. You got involved in the 30-day program?
Mm-hmm, I did.
And why did you decide to do that?
It's personal for me. I wanted to see, actually, I like the children. I do. I like the children.
And you see the children and get a chance to help them, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, I love it.
A lot of children coming.
Love it.
And that's why we're determined to keep helping the children at this time. And you can help us to do that. We help our legal defense fund because Satan walks around like a roaring lion seeking those he may devour. He wants us to stop sheltering the homeless. We're going to keep doing that in the name of Jesus through the power of our resurrected Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm asking you to just continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. That's why we're working to continue to be there when people are hurting. And I also want to ask you to pray for our prison outreach ministry. I want to go to right now to Mark Glenn. He heads up our Cry Justice Division. Now we have a transportation program for prisoner families. I want to tell you a little bit about that. I'm sharing this with you, praying that you will pray for this program, this ministry, and every outreach of the New Life Evangelistic Center. Let's go to Mark.
There is a new program started by New Life Evangelistic Center in cooperation with the Stepping in the Light Ministries, and it's called the Prison Transportation Program. And what it does, it allows individuals and family members and friends to go to Jefferson City or Algoa prison, correctional centers to visit their loved ones. And right now I'm joined by Gwen, who's actually part of the program.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. Now, you call about the program, right? What does the program mean to you, and why are you using it?
My brother is in Jefferson City, and it has really been hard to be able to go and visit him. So I had been searching out an organization to be able to go and visit him, and he was able to come up with Reverend Ray is who he told me to ask for. So I had no idea it was New Life Evangelistic Center, but I'm glad because it gave me the opportunity to be able to find a way to be able to go and see my brother.
No. You had mentioned to me earlier that it was real difficult for you to find an organization it was inconsiderate times and the cost was real high.
Yes, it was, you know, and you can't beat this right here. You know, I mean, this people don't have a lot of money and this really would help. You know, it's helping me and it's enabling my mother to be able to go, you know. I'm really grateful that my brother was able to come up with this program, you know.
Right. And we want to let you know that the program leaves on the second Saturday of each month. We are, you know, we believe in trying to encourage family members and friends to visit their loved ones at an economical cost. So it doesn't cost an arm and a leg. I've heard of people who had to get hotel rooms and had to hire somebody, rent a car to go all the way to Jefferson City.
Yeah, they have like an Agape housing up in Jefferson City where you go like on a Friday and stay for the weekend. But this way we're able to go and visit and then still be able to come back home, which is less costing because I really don't have hotel money to be able to go up there and stay. But I appreciate New Life Evangelistic Center for bringing this program into view.
Now, if you want more information about the program, you can call me. My name is Pastor Mark Glenn. You can call me at 314-881-3220, or you can call the number that you see on your screen, or contact us that way, or contact us through New Life Evangelistic Center for this program. It's called the Prison Transportation Program, and it's for you to visit your loved ones who are incarcerated. Thank you.
Thank you, each and every one of you that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center. There's so many different things that the Lord is doing, whether it's the Veterans Coming Home program in Springfield, Missouri, the day shelter in Springfield, day shelter in St. Louis, overnight shelters, the transportation program among prisoners, just trying to live out Matthew chapter 25, verses 31 to 48. And the needs right now, the weather's been so hot, and New Life Evangelistic Center's working to get fans to needy families. And we're doing that in spite of the fact that we have $250,000 we got to pay in bills now. And by faith, we're continuing to step out and buy these fans and these air conditioners. And so I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Please pray and believe God with us for a financial miracle. I want to go to Ray as he talks to a couple individuals. They've gotten fans. Please go to God and believe with us. Let's exercise our faith for a financial miracle here at the New Life Evangelistic Center.
I'm talking with Darlene. Darlene, you're here with your son today and your children to get a fan, right?
Yes, I am.
And I know that you brought a letter from the doctor explaining exactly why it's needed. Tell us how important this is for your family to get this fan.
This fan is very important. I can't run my electric like that. My air, it kick on and it kick back off. Warren constantly saying that he can't breathe. His room is very stuffy. One eye vents in our house is not pulling the air through the house. So this fan has saved me a lot of money. I won't have to have that $200 and $300 electric bill. So I appreciate it. I mean, I couldn't afford it at this moment, at this time.
Well, God bless you. We're glad that people have given so that we now can share this fan with your family. We trust that it will be a real blessing for you. We recommend that you put it in or near the window so it blows out during the day, and turn around at night to have it blowing in at night.
Okay.
God bless you.
God bless you.
The heat has come here to St. Louis and to the Midwest, and many people are needing fans and air conditioners. I'm talking here with George. George went and got a letter from the clinic, and he has a medical need for a fan, and we're glad that we can share this with him. Tell us how important it is for you to get this fan, George.
Well, I have COPD, and I need it. I have breathing problems, and this fan came in real handy.
Well, God bless you. We also encourage you to be sure to have your windows open a little bit and keep that air circulating. We recommend that you have it blow the hot air out during the day and the turn it around at night near the window so it'll blow the cooler air in.
I will.
And remember, it's through the Lord Jesus. He's the one that makes it possible.
God bless you. Thank you very much.
There are so many people that are facing so many needs. The New Life Evangelistic Center is trying to be there when people are hurting. And Shelley, during your time here at the ministry, you've learned about a lot of these needs that are being met, haven't you?
Yes, I have, Reverend Rice.
Well, what's your reaction?
Well, what I see here is that the need of the people is so great, but the compassion and the services and the fulfilling of these needs are being done day by day, despite the trials that are being put forth with the city hall trying to shut us down. But with all these other shelters being shut down, where does a person have to turn?
What would you have done if this place hadn't been open?
Oh, I don't even want to think about that.
And to think about the women and the little children that have to sleep out on the streets.
It's heartbreaking, but it's a reality. It's a reality. So without a service such as what New Life Evangelistic Center provides, where would these people go?
And I'm asking you to please pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center and believe God with us for miracles now. I know He's a miracle-working God. And I thank God for those of you that are standing in faith with us and sharing those special gifts. We need them.
Amen.
This summer, facing critical needs, the hot weather. We're having to get more fans and air conditioners and continue to create the cooling center for women, children in St. Louis and in Springfield, Missouri, and Columbia, I mean, and Potosi and Joplin. I'm asking, just please go to God and pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. We urgently need prayer, and I believe in the power of prayer.
Amen.
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 And yes, will you pray that God will just provide? Right now, we could put to work $10 million if the Lord was to give it tomorrow, helping so many people. I mean, I don't want to turn it. It hurts me every time I have to tell someone we don't have money to help in our needy fund, or we don't have a fan available or an air conditioner available. And we've added so much to our credit cards already by buying these fans and air conditioners and trying to help people that we need a miracle. But He's a miracle-working God. Amen.
He certainly is, Reverend Rice.
So as you've gotten involved in the work here and you've helped write some of the history and you've been involved working with the women and the children and help at night shelter and all of that, what's it doing for you personally?
It's actually fulfilling my heart and a need for me to be making a difference within God's kingdom. The beauty of this program is not only just the spiritual, the compassion, but the true giving, Reverend Rice, that is given across the board, regardless who comes through these doors.
So it's not just a job you're doing begrudgingly.
No, it's with open heart.
With joy. And looking for miracles, right?
Well, there are either here every day.
We just have to ask Him to show us the miracles. And they're around us, all around us. We invite you to participate in such. If you'd like to be a volunteer, whether it's in St. Louis or Springfield or Potosi or Joplin or wherever it may be, call us 314-881-3218. That's 314-881-3218. And then be ready for the miracles. And I want to ask you to please pray for us. And as the Holy Spirit speaks to your heart right now, send that $500 gift. That's what He's saying, $100. Or even $1,000 or $5,000. Just be obedient to the Lord, whatever it may be. And partner with us here at New Life Evangelistic Center because you are needed. There's so many people that need you, so many opportunities for service. If you haven't checked out the website to just see some of them, go to newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. And I just want to say thank you, Lord Jesus, for our caring partners. And I'm asking a special blessing for each one of them right now. In Jesus' name, receive your blessing today. In the name of Jesus.